Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Dot DJ Productions. And tonight we're going to be finally running on the Castleman's Railway in the more or less complete state. Woo! And I think there's some people hanging around, but I'm just going to go join them anyway. There's some people, just, you know, say hello.
Hello.
Oh.
Well, one's alive.
Yeah, one of them's alive. Anyway, yeah, we're going to be running properly over the Castleman tonight. Because I think I've pretty much completed it now. So I'm happy. You know, when I say completed it, I more or less mean it's going to probably look the best it's going to be. So, yeah, I suppose I'll show you guys around now that I've actually finished it. But first of all, I'm going to show you the map because it looks a bit different. So, this, like, from... Oh, God. From down here... All the way to over here is now the extent of the Castleman's Railway, which runs from, instead of running from originally Wimborne, it runs from Broadstone, which is a park and ride station, and it runs all the way up to Holmesley. Well, it's on my channel because I've just literally seen it on my channel because I literally just clicked on it. And other people can literally see it, so... So basically, you two just interrupted whatever I'm doing just to be annoying.
Sorry.
Bitches. Anyway, so here we are at Wimborne Motor Power Depot where there's no turntable at the moment because I haven't zoomed out and then back in again. There you go, now that's the turntable. We're at Wimborne Motor Power Depot. And we're going to be basically running the tank engine, so 15163, which is actually a fictional number. We're going to be running that to Broadstone and back, which is essentially a branch line. Because the original Broadstone station was basically in my history. Well, in real history, the real station has been overtaken by a road. But you'll see what I mean when we get to Broadstone, basically what is a park and ride. It's only a short branch. But then we're going to take Windward Islands up to Ringwood. We're going to swap over to a DMU at Holmesley. No, to go down to Holmesley and Brockenhurst because we're going to use the mainline connection. Oh, excuse me. But I'm going to talk about the operations of the line as we go, seeing as I've finally completed this route. So without further ado, I'm both about going to collect our coaches. So... Anyway, so this is Wimborne MPD. I've obviously edited the sheds because I stopped doing my route build stream while I did the last couple of bits on the route. And I must admit, it does look very nice now. Although I thought it looked pretty nice anyway, but it looks a bit nicer. So, yeah, we're going to be running 15163 on this part of the route, which is 439 class. Now, I do have all the liveries for it, but I actually do actually really like this. Oh, excuse me, sorry, my stomach's going iffy. Also, my co-pilot for the evening apparently just really quiet for some reason, so yeah. It'll be basically me just talking and driving. Because I wanted to show off the route now that it's... Well, no, but... Oh, okay, never mind. We will start that again. Because didn't load features here. Forgot one very, very important thing.
Points?
Yeah. So now I've got to sit here and wait for me to load that up again.
Yeah. It's only 4 minutes and you've already done a derailment.
Yeah, well.
You've already crashed Blimp Scotland.
It's not Blimp Scotland.
It's Blimp Scotland.
It's not. It's a patio tank.
It's Blimp Scotland.
Patio tank.
Chris said it has air tanks, therefore it is a fucking blimp.
Yeah, well, it's got patios, so it's a patio tank.
In Zeppelin, Scotland.
Yeah.
Well, it's not called Hindenburg, Scotland, because, you know, that's it's a bit small.
I don't care. Anyway, Anthony's wrong. Is it Led Zeppelin?
I should avoid that joke.
Well, it's not made of lead, is it? It's made of iron and steel. Also.
Yes.
I hate these loading screens. Hurry up, get on with it.
Hello.
You sit here watching these loading screens forever, right? Literally, my loading screen's better because. Well, actually. I blame the Mormons.
Hooray. Well, they'll do shit.
Oh, wow, that was quick.
I blame our own people.
I blame it on everyone. Right, let's press play and, try this again, okay? So, hang on. We're no longer loading.
Now, someone mentioned the weight of it. If I could put like, the whole GTA 5 weighted sort of. Overlay sort of thing on the derailment.
No, you're not, young boxing man. Right, this time, do you think maybe I should think about setting the points?
Yeah.
It would be an idea, I think.
It'd be a smart thing to do.
So as I was saying a minute ago, anyway, we're going to go to Broadstone first. Which is basically a branch line. And then we're going to go to Brockenhurst. Now that whistle that just blew was awesome. Huh? And it's so good when you're running along with this thing.
I was thinking actually.
Did it hurt?
It certainly hurts now, considering it's already been doing a lot of overtime.
Okay.
It might blow up. You know, Chris asked if you were going to do anything like
this. Oh, you know what? Hang on, Anthony. I can't hear a word you're saying because of this train. Because it's blowing off lots of steam and stuff, so. Right, okay, go again.
You know, Chris was asking you if you were going to do anything else with this thing once.
Mhm.
I was just thinking, would you do some, for example, maybe with like showcasing 419 itself, maybe doing something like on its travels?
Could do.
It's all about the base, no beats.
Although I have looked at those other liveries, Anthony. I might show you them in a bit if you want, actually. You know, the, like, 1970s and 80s, like, dark, very dark blue.
Yeah, that's the one I was talking about saying, because I do like that. If only because I like seeing the pictures and trains that she'll look at.
Hang on a sec, I need to do something. I need to adjust my audio levels. Because, as per usual, you lot are just really quiet for some reason. No, don't think. No. I don't mean that. I mean, I only wanted you to talk for a minute. Anyway, hold on. Anthony, say something.
What are you doing? Why is your life a weird blowing up 100,000 terrorists?
Thank you.
Okay, interesting. I cannot find the volume control for Discord. Which is strange.
Fair enough. like already.
Gav, what are you giggling at?
A shitty meme on Telegram. It's like, it's about like what animals need horsepower, etc. Like, this guy used a lifeline for this. It's like the whole salesman meme right underneath it.
Fascinating.
What are the memes on here? Well, I've got anything else better to do this evening as well.
Well, I'm going to do this bit as a cab ride anyway from the, not cab ride, like GoPro, I guess, from the footplate. Yeah. So, yeah, let's do this. So we're going to go from Wimborne to Broadstone first. Off we go. Got enough to feel like I'm setting my signals up wrong. Tom, you guys can't deny that that lighting is lovely.
I agree, Tom.
Oh, we've attracted the man with the tash.
Again?
What, Chris?
Yeah, I don't know why. Like, every time I see him, I just instantly think, that moustache.
You're just weird. Now, I want the ladies and gents to check this out in a second. Because we've got a bridge here that's on a 1 in 25 gradient. That's right, you heard me. That bridge coming up is 1 in 25. To clear a road. And to raise from this part over to the, thing. So this could be fun.
I do like this camera, this one that's sat down by the splasher.
That's what I like as well. That's why I'm using it to show off this section.
It's It's the same one where you can see the valve gear.
Yeah.
You can turn around and see the valve gear as well, isn't it?
Yeah, basically, it's this one that looks inside the valve gear, but I face it forward like this, because it's like someone bolted a GoPro onto the front of the engine.
It's a red top.
Hmm. Also, because this is this, what is technically the like the newest extension to the Castleman's Railway in the sense of in the preservation era anyway, like in my pretend one, and this was the last section to be built, that's why it got more of this the ground, gravel, because it's supposed to mimic the King's Coat to East Grinstead section on the Bluebell, as you can probably tell. Bit of a climb going this way anyway.
Sorry, I've just seen one Gareth put in news. This guy used a lifeline for this. Equals roughly 746 watts. What animal-based unit is used to measure the rate at which work is done? Horsepower, donkey strength, llama thrust, or zebra force? Flaps roof of car. This baby has the thrust of 340 llamas under the hood.
I'm sorry, but it's sort of like, chef, chef, chef. It's the worst that could happen.
Death and destruction.
Yes, indeed, Rooney.
Ugh, fuck. Okay. Is she working? Thank you.
Suddenly, mums, memes.
Sorry, our Trace was cut. Changed and came in complaining about her hair still.
Wait, what?
Oh, Tracy's trying to still get rid of that colour for her hair, isn't she, at the moment? So she can...
Ah, yes, the human torch.
She's not the human torch. Leave her alone.
She was the human torch.
Was. She retired. So anyway, what I'm going to say is this is Broadstone, but... What I'm going to do is lift the camera up and show you guys. In real life, this road here exists. It's not as long and big as it is, but... In reality... Hang on, I've just got to make sure I stop my engine in the right place. In reality, this railway line used to go further than where this is. That should stop in the right place. No, the railway line used to go down there. The Broadstone Station used to be here. And where that bridge is in the distance used to be where the end of the platforms were. So what I've done is imagine it that, yes, this road did exist. And this road was built on the old station-like site. But because this bit was part of the trail, the Castleman's Railway, you know, company decided this was going to be the furthest they could get. And they took advantage of that and set it up to be almost like a park and ride. So, yeah, it sort of got sprinkles of Norden, East Grinstead, Wootton. It's got sprinkles and inspirations from a lot of places, but, you know, just to bore people, that's what I think anyway. And I like the idea of this being a little branch line. So, yeah. Suppose I better go back then. Thanks for that lovely sound of interest, Anthony and Gareth.
Oh, sorry, Tom.
Oh, look, they weren't even paying bloody attention.
A little more in the engine.
What, because it goes chuff?
Yes. Oh. And that is Scottish.
Well, yeah, that is.
I'm waiting for Scottish engines, I admit this.
Even though it's a fat M7. Oh yeah, when the sun bounces off it, it looks splendid. Has Chris noticed the interesting thing about this loco yet? I wonder. Well, if he's not watching, I mean, I'll tell the audience later on, but if he guesses what it is, then yeah.
Wait, what is
that? I'm telling you, yeah, I'm going to wait and see if Chris responds. If he's not watching it, then I'll tell you guys later. But there's something interesting about the locomotive, the particular member anyway.
I mean, you did said earlier, didn't you, that its existence is questionable.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he's there, he's asking.
Wait, does that he doesn't know?
Yeah, he's asked what's different.
Okay, well, 15163 was not... It's really weird, actually, because this was the first number I put down for the loco, custom number, because I noticed that I couldn't put a number down, and for some reason I'm thinking about, oh, And then I realised this one wasn't actually ever an engine that existed, 15163. Because it doesn't matter where I've looked it up. And also I then found out that the numbering sequence was gapped in certain places. So you had 15161, 15162, 15164. So 15163 never existed. So I've nabbed it for the Castlemans. So it's basically the Castleman's version of Lino, if you like.
I'd say basically it's like Scottish Lino.
Yeah, Scottish Lino.
So it's a blimp. So Lino has now become a Scottish blimp. That's good.
I kind of regret not putting another tank engine down. There was another tank engine I wanted to drive and I completely forgot to put it down. Coal tank.
Coal top. Oh, it's annoying. I've had that now downloaded for ages, but because I've been, like...
busy?
Yeah, I still haven't been able to drive it yet.
Well, we need to fix that soon, Anthony, because it's a very nice thing to drive. So you basically need to, one, hope that you get your corp work back, and two, murder someone.
I've written that off basically. It's too late to deal with that now. I'm gonna have to just basically push on from where I was.
God.
Also, I see a hello and welcome back to the hello file.
In this episode, Tom is not driving something in Keighley Worth Valley Railway Red.
Correct, I'm not. It's in an NMS red.
Isn't it a funny thing, really?
Somebody has brought up the time Lino went to Scotland.
This is what he became.
So what, Lino goes for a run through Scotland and comes out like a blimp?
Yeah, he just gets a bit fat while he's up there.
Tom's all take tips from Brian.
You know, it's weird. You know, I basically have this tendency to give all of Chris's models nicknames.
Yeah, because you're weird.
I basically was skimming through like all his models to see which ones haven't been given nicknames. There's actually a surprisingly large amount of them that don't.
Yeah, like for example, you haven't given the coal tank a nickname, Anthony.
But coal tank is bay. Well, it's not bay, but it's, you know, it's...
No, you've cemented it now. Coal tank's nickname is now officially bay.
I'll tell you what, very nice, like next Friday, like Friday the 10th, once I'm home from, you know... Britain,
you know I'm going to be on holiday, like, right?
Oh, rip.
So, how long are you away from? Right.
I'm away from this Saturday, from this Saturday coming up to the following Saturday.
Hurt rip.
So you go holiday, the same day I go, you come back...
By the way, I want to show people the extent of this, the extent of this gradient on this bridge. So hold on, like, you know, the camera is at a flat angle. Look how bloody steep that bridge is.
Ouch. Productions is asking, where are you going?
Cornwall, funnily enough.
Hi Riley. Wait, what? Even though it is technically false advertising, the guy with Cornwall as his last name doesn't actually live
in Cornwall. I know.
In any case, I'm going to disappear for about 15 minutes. It's still a bit...
Okay. Well...
Right, now we've got rid of that Anthony kid.
So we're going to now do a loco change already. Because now we're going to use the Jub Jub.
Chirp, chirp.
The idea is that, like, the whole point of this particular section of railway line, anyway, is that if you, like, want to do turntable demonstrations, you can literally make it so that a passenger train goes up to Broadstone, and when it comes back, you see another locomotive come down and get turned on the turntable whilst the loco change is going on.
Nice.
So that's a good idea, I think. Adds a bit more flexibility to the timetable as well, because you can use this section to change the loco rather than bouldering up the station a lot of the time. If that makes sense.
Yeah, because does the 439 actually have the water capacity to do a full run of the route on one tank?
I can make it go from one end to the other. I mean, it's only... I think the railway... I think from Broadstone to Holmesley, which is the main, you know, the accepted running line, if you like. I think it runs at about 20-ish miles.
Not bad. So that would give what the West Somerset a run for its money.
It's basically the southern version of the West Somerset. Except slightly more interesting in layout.
Yeah, because I think the closest you get to a northern version of the West Somerset's the North York Moors.
Yeah.
Because
The Midland version into the Severn Valley.
Severn Valley, yeah.
And then you got the Wensleydale, which is for the northeast, isn't it?
Suddenly, Ethan chimed in. Cook.
Yeah, probably.
Champagne, cocaine, gasoline. Look out, he's going to fart.
So, everybody say goodbye to the 439 and going into the shed.
Bye, Scotland.
So, we're going to go from Scotland to the Windward Islands.
Nice.
What are you giggles wicking at?
I'm just looking through bloody Facebook real quick.
You sad ass.
And there's a meme with the caption, when you thought you were going to have a bad day, then your best friend rolls up. Beep beep, you sad fuck!
And now for some, superior traction, I guess. In the respect of, you know, Stania being Stania.
And going from an 044 to a 3-cylinder 460.
Yeet.
That.
Oh god, I've got an itchy ear. I've got to itch my ear before we carry on.
Itchy ear?
Well, man, I hate having it when I've got an itchy ear. Anyway,
Railway Productions does bring up a good point.
What's that?
If you add the 6 miles on to Whitby, North York Moors is technically longer than
the West Somerset, the West Somerset. Isn't it?
But that 6 miles is owned by
Network Rail.
And Northern occasionally go.
Okay.
And occasionally.
That's the weirdest way of someone saying that, but okay.
Tom, this is me we're talking about, for fuck's sake. What is it? He's falling in the water.
Man, that is a gorgeous looking engine though. Especially in the morning light.
Definitely. So the gold lining with the maroon.
Crimson.
Crimson. Shush, my Wikipedia article says maroon, okay? I'm kidding. Do you need to cover the jib-jibs at some point?
Yes, you do.
Hello, and welcome to the Express Black Five. Oh, sorry, I mean Jubilees.
The Express Black Five. You cheeky fuck.
I mean...
It basically is, though, to be fair.
It is literally a three-cylinder version of the Black Five. But...
You'll find it's actually more related to the Baby Scots.
Yeah.
Cause these are actually the bloody Patriots is what I meant.
Mm.
They're more closely related to Patriots.
Than to the Black Force.
Yeah. Because they were numbered directly after the
Patriots.
Yeah.
Yeah, because the Patriots had the 5500 numbering block, didn't they?
Yeah, 5500 to 5551. And Silver Jubilee was 5552.
Mm. Yeah, because the RMS had to play around with numbering on the Black Fives because of that.
Pretty much.
Yeah, they're just like... Well, I mean, we could just renumber the entirety of one class. Nah, just give them different numbers.
Yeah, just get... Fuck it, whatever, we'll just number them differently. No one will notice.
Yeah.
Well, I'll get the locomotive sorted out when we actually get to the station.
Right away. And she's off, ladies and gentlemen. Can people not have loud exhausts on their cars?
I wish.
Barbados.
What?
For some reason, it's Darby's nickname.
Barbados.
Yeah. So I have my window open. And I'm just like, fuck. Hopefully it's not too much background noise polluting the audio of the stream.
Not really, I can't hear anything, barely.
Neither can I.
Right, I've got to go...
I couldn't hear anything.
Oh, for God's sake.
Anyway,
I've got to go to what is essentially the best place to take a screenshot on this route, I'd say.
Is it that bridge?
Yeah. Mainly because, right, I find that this section here, you could essentially run photo charters over. Because you can get photographers down on Thingy Bob, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know why, just seeing you change over from the 439 to the Jubilee, it's something I wish more heritage railways did, because
it's a nice concept, isn't it, that you can watch a loco change happen from the train.
Yeah, because occasionally,
mainly at galas, I see that happen, but not on day-to-day running. Oh.
You have a super chat, Tom.
Already?
Yeah, from Scoobert Dubert.
I think that person has done that before. I shall have a look at it in a sec. Let me just stop the train and I'll have a look.
Suddenly, Tom applied the brakes. They went, is that a 101? Or is that just BR Blue Coaches?
BR Blue Coaches.
One of them's not that bad.
Right, let's have a look at it.
Oh, you locked your wheels up
a little. Oh, I'm skint, but who cares? Oh my god. Cheers, dude.
Hey, Tom, can I super chat you £1,000 to say the same thing?
I mean, if you want, but I wouldn't recommend it.
Yeah, considering that's the money I have to live off till I go home in June.
So, yeah, Wimborne Station has changed a little bit since I last showed people it. So,
is that a restaurant car?
No. The blue coaches are the sleeping cars for the volunteers who work up here.
Oh, nice.
Down there is the restaurant car. You've got a restaurant car and a break that you can basically sit and have whatever. But you've also got, a bay platform, the main platform. You've also got the really, really big carriage sheds here, which are empty at the moment because all our carriages are on holiday.
Because I think I sort of,
I was gonna put some cars in here though, but I haven't done that yet, so we're just gonna say it's early morning, so no one's here yet,
no one's actually bothered to turn up yet.
And also, but I decided to actually make some of my own signs, as you can see, so each station now has its own name signs, so that's nice.
Real quickly going back to the switching locos. I know occasionally the North York Moors will do that. They'll have their standard form mogul haul the train from Whitby to Gromont, and then I think this happened in the summer. Eric Tracy.
Jesus.
Yeah. Scuba. If you need it to live, stop. And then Tracy would take it on to Pickering and back.
Feddies.
And it go, hoot.
Well, let's go.
But I don't want to go.
Oh, James, look at that.
Do you not make it better?
What?
Grizzly V2 Antiques.
No. It just wouldn't, James. I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, gosh. Oh, that's the next LNER logo I plan on featuring.
Uh-oh. So anyway, we're now leaving Wimborne. Next station is the fictional Canford Bottom. Which is actually in the town of Canford Bottom, but there was never a station here. So.
Were they too busy arsing around?
No, there just never was a station there in real life. There's like 3 stations on this route that never existed, and that is the next one, Canford Bottom, the one after that, which is Ferndown and Staphill, and then another one in Burley. But Westmoor's, Ashley Heath, Ringwood, and Holmesley existed, and so did Wimborne and Broadstone.
Were Don't you work at like the old Ashley Heath station or something?
Well, I work what was the crossing keeper's house, personal house. It's the building itself is my shop, so.
I think Matt. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, we're going under the dive under.
Not the dive under.
Well, no, look. If you look at the stream, you'll see what I mean by the dive under.
Yeah.
The railway line dives under the main line for clearance. Under the main road, even, for clearance sake. Oh, yeah. Man, look at that. That was lovely. I love it when I drive BMG stuff, because it look. Well, obviously, I love stallion machines, so I just find they all look amazing. But couple it with these weather conditions, and it's like,
Photogenic as fuck, boy.
Problem is, when I do these sort of streams, it's trying to find that nice angle.
Now with transport fever, I've sort of been getting a bit more arty with the camera angles, but then again, you can't really muck about with the weather at all on that game.
Why am I getting loads of super chats now? I mean, cheers, but if people actually have money they need to live on, please don't. Only because I value people's actual monetary situations.
Like, instead of getting money via Twitch, just do it via Patreon.
I mean, that is true.
That is a very good segue, Gareth.
Right, here we are at Canford Bottom.
It doesn't look shit. Which jib are you driving, Tom?
Windward Islands, 5637. The Castleman's have only Jubilee. And yes, we saved it via time travel, travel paradox.
What's that?
Before you think about it, James, and it hurts your head, yes, it was. Windward Islands, number 5637. Was the one that was destroyed at Harrow and Wiltstone.
Yeah, I was about to say that was the one that bit it in that crash.
Not anymore.
Because the Castleman lives in an alternate universe.
Yeah, in our pocket dimension, it was a different Jubilee that crashed due to time travel. Because my idea is that with the time travel paradox that we currently live in on the DR. That's how this railway line exists, so engines that don't, like, that could have crashed or whatever, or blah blah blah, exist still on this railway line, because it never happened in this universe, if that makes sense.
Nice.
So before we leave here, let's make sure. Yeah. By the way, James, have you noticed that there's a very, very short distance between these two stations? It's kind of pointless. The reason being, though, is that this station hasn't got a passing loop, the next one has. And that passing loop is the only one between Wimborne and Ashley Heath. So Canford Bottom serves a village, but Ferndown and Stapehill serves two that are further away.
Okay, yeah.
But Canford Bottom is like literally hang on, wait, if I zoom the camera, oh god. Canford Bottom's new station is literally in the middle of Canford Bottom, as you can see.
Yeah.
Which is surprising that they've never had a station in real life. Because Canford Bottom's a pretty big... Canford and Canford Magnum are pretty big places, so...
Yeah, you would have thought...
Even a Holt or something.
Yeah, like, you would have thought the LSWR and later the Southern... would have gone... Ooh, they're kind of quite populated. Do you think they want trains?
And I mean, the problem is that the only way to have gotten a train from Canford Magna or Ferndown or wherever, I mean, for Ferndown, they could have gone to Westmoors.
Yeah.
They're quite far to go. But if you lived in Canford Magna or Canford Bottom, you'd have to go all the way back to Wimborne. So my idea is just, like, you know, giving these towns and villages their own stations.
Yeah, no, I think that's actually decent.
I like that idea, anyway. I like the idea of it. It's a bit like, oh, God. You know, like, on... Well, big example, Swanage Railway. Basically, yeah. Originally, it only had... The only stations on the route were Swanage, Corfe Castle, and Wareham. But in preservation, because they can't go all the way to Wareham, obviously, the stations they have are Swanage, then you've got Hurston Holt, then you've got Harman's Cross, then Corfe Castle, and then Norden Park and Ride. So, in preservation, new stations do get built. Yeah, and that's my idea for these stations.
What, wasn't Bishop's Lydiard getting a new station or something?
I'm sure Bishop's Lydiard was a station already.
Yeah, no,
It was Norton Fitzwarren that has a different station.
Yeah, I think that's what I might be getting onto.
Bloody hell, I'm trying to think of other places that have new build stations.
Let me just do a little bit of research real quick.
So we're now approaching Ferndown and Stape Hill. With the green train in the siding here. The green permanent way train.
Yeah.
Which is mainly green, hence why it's called the Green Train.
Nice. It doesn't actually say when it was built. That's annoying.
But this is... You wouldn't believe it when you see these things on these routes, but you wouldn't believe this didn't used to exist either. This was never anything. The station.
That's fucking crazy, mate.
Oh yeah, this place also has its own sign as well.
Nice.
Yay! Ferndown and Stape Hill.
No, Cara Belga has just made a good point.
What?
Smallbrook Junction didn't originally have a station.
Yep, that's very true.
And Lake didn't have a station on the Isle of Wight.
Yep.
And I was going to say Newton Dale Holt, but...
Oh god, I'm trying to think of other ones. I'm gonna sit here thinking about it now while we go from here to West Moors.
A nice relaxing stream actually, Stape Hill.
Well, it's just to finally show off the route itself and how much fun I can now, well, say fun in a relative sense. I'm going to try and make a proper scenario for this at some point anyway, or a set of scenarios.
Antonio Banderas
has returned.
Did you think you could hide?
Yes.
What do you think of the signs anyway, James, the totems?
I think they look really good, actually, mate.
I always find that adding a totem or a name board of any sort makes the route look a little bit more your own, and also it makes it look a little bit more real, I guess.
Yeah. the signalman was slacking that day. He didn't put the signals down after the jug left.
Someone just pointed out the shadows on the trees. That's something else. That's why I put these, when I've been doing these route build streams, you see me putting a lot of these trees near the line, because these are the times of day I run services as. So you get to really see those shadows come on the end, on the trains. So I think it looks lovely.
Ooh.
Bit of lag there.
Yeah. Also, we have a question from Sir Liv.
Okay.
What recommendations would you give to someone wanting to learn how to build a route that looks as good as this?
Spam lots of 3D trees. But mix them up a bit. I suppose my best advice is just make it sort of like, I don't know, whatever you could use. Use it, be creative with it.
Forward to a run on an off your walls this summer.
No, it's not.
I mean, my mum will be pissed because I'll have soot in my hair, but. Oh, shit. Sorry about that, just elbowed my mic. Okay, another one. What loco would you like to see in TS next, Tom?
Oh god. That's actually a really tough question, I'm not sure.
Can I answer it?
If it's a BR Standard 2 tank, then no.
In Keighley Worth Valley Railway Red.
Right, both of you dead now. Stop undermining me with editing.
Editing.
Depot points. Depot points.
Dildos.
Dildos, said Barry.
I thought I was holding chicken pies, not dildos. Look, I want to see in TS, my prayers will be answered the minute Stainmore is released.
Oh, the T 4297.
Indeed.
Wasn't there one about a new city class?
Well, I'd like to see a 2800 at some point. Not looking at anybody in particular.
Who even has it now?
I don't know.
I think SSS doesn't sound there.
It's a jub-jub.
Is
it's
it?
It's a ripped your face off jub-jub.
Well, yeah. She survived on the Castleman, remember?
So what, they literally took like someone that had its...
No. Basically, the history's different. A different Jubilee was smashed up. We shall call it Colliper.
No.
Oh, wait, no. We're going to call it Galatea.
I think we should call it Keith instead.
What about John?
I guess that's not my one being killed. What?
Yeah, I see Princess Royals come up a lot, actually. I imagine if anyone's going to do it, it probably would be Boss Man.
Well, I hope yeah. Because his would look amazeballs.
We don't have a Princess Royal TS, do we?
Not yet.
No.
Look at that.
There.
Mm.
Oh my.
I smell chicken pies. No.
And greeting. Chicken pies, seriously?
Do not call it Nigel.
Am I like the only one in this, like, who actually really, really likes the idea of this station?
Sorry, Tom?
Oh, just the fact that, like, you know, Westmoreland is based on Groombridge on the Spa Valley, and I really love the concept of the design, but...
Yeah?
I don't know, I just feel like I'm the only one who does.
What? Like, the station building's, like...
There. It's on the old platform, but because the new one is on... The new platform is on this side, basically, they had to build... Because of landowning issues, they had to build, the way they did, like, on a different alignment. Like, also due to the fact that, as you can clearly see, there are some houses in front of the platform.
Let's go, Step!
Ow.
I should have Danish pastry in the chat.
But the thing...
Who's gonna absolutely kill you?
The thing I will say, though, is that I reimagined Westmoreland a little bit, because in real life, Westmoreland didn't have that sort of extravagant station. So... You know.
Well, James. We could also say, you know, they are mostly, but this is a steam rail bus. Stop that noise, Bella. It would keep her of porridge.
This is my mean poop.
Match Anthony, there's also another thing we could say.
And I have a dropkick sword waiting for you if you say it.
It's not going to be what you think it is, don't worry, Anthony. Trains are better than trams.
That's a given.
Ding ding!
Surprise, motherfucker!
Is there a reason why James is suddenly really, really loud, or is it just me?
Sorry?
Is there a reason why you're really, really loud all of a sudden, or is it just me?
That's just you.
And yet, Gwyn is still really quiet.
I'm not quiet, for fuck's sake.
And we have triggered Sep. I don't know if I was just having like a hyper moment or something.
Are you watching it all, Gwyn?
I can pop your stream up.
So no, he's not.
No. I was going to ask you what you thought of how...
No, it's a click away.
Never mind.
Yeah, I'm watching it now. What up?
I was hoping you were watching it anyway, just so I could say what did you think of
the
movie so far.
Well, I only just got
so...
on my computer.
Oh, well, that's just because you're ugly, isn't it? Considering that what I might do after this... After I've done this run up and down, I might load up the... Southampton to Weymouth route and run this section just so everyone can actually bloody see how much scenery work I've done to this route.
Yeah.
So what I'll do is I'll go from I'll go down to Brockenhurst and back to Wimborne, and then what I'll do is I'll load up back at Brockenhurst and go all the way down to Hanworthy via Ringwood. So. Well, the people are actually interested in the history of this area and the differences that I've made, and that hopefully was alright, but to people like James who are just a fucking prick, then it's fine.
Speaking of fucking pricks, shut up outside!
Oh god, I thought you were talking about Anty then.
No, but I do like the sick burn that Seb's just done.
Is he sick?
He's just essentially just gone to Gary. You fucking ponies.
At least my trams aren't. I'm talking about the ponies and the friendship and the wrapping up of the winter.
But I do have a question for Seb.
I don't.
Have you just activated my Alan card?
So forth, Guion?
And the scenery?
Mm-hmm.
It's very dense. It is very well detailed. There is a lot of shrubs by the line. And a fence. I like the trees, actually. Those trees you're going up to now. The ones where the branches are quite high up.
The pine. The pine tree, Quill. Do you not have pine trees in Wales?
The ones where the branches are really high up.
Yeah. Pine trees, Guillaume.
They're pine trees?
Mm-hmm, they are pine trees. Have you literally just went and searched pine trees?
Yes. I think he has.
No, you're thinking of the wrong one. And yeah, that's my point. Right, no. There's a pine tree on your left-hand side, but on the right-hand side, a really tall, slender one.
Slender tree? Oh, no! It's slender tree!
That's what was throwing me. I was like, no, not the pine tree. I know what the pine tree looks like.
What is it?
It's a different style of... It's a different type of pine tree, basically.
Is it?
Mm-hmm. Well, it could be a poplar.
A what?
A poplar
tree. That was in London.
Oh, a poplar tree.
Mm-hmm.
That would make more sense.
James, this is actually Heath, by the way.
Yeah, I'd say it's more like a poplar tree. Not popular, though.
Is that birdcage stock in the bay platform?
I'll show you in a sec. So what you've got is, this is a permanent bay here, James. These are permanently berthed here on a separate piece of track, if I come around here to show you.
Yeah.
They're completely isolated because they are part of the, like a little cafe, if you like.
Okay, so
they're permanently berthed there with a canopy as a buffet style restaurant style whatever.
Yeah, that reminds me. I can't remember what station it is on the Riviera, modern route.
Mm.
But it has a bunch of chocolate and cream coaches.
Yeah. Just
like that.
Yeah, it's also reminiscent of what used to be called Hearn Station, which is near me again. It's on this route, actually, which is, if I've just zoomed out to the map. Hearn Station is there, and nowadays it is called the Avon Causeway Pub, the old station building. And at the old station, there is part of the old platform, and they've got a Pullman car there.
Nice.
Which they use for extra capacity for, you know, the eatery. Anyway, my shop is just literally that building right there that we're looking at is supposed to represent my shop, James.
Wow.
Basically where the platform, because all that exists nowadays is the part of the platform we're in, and one of the Ashley Heath signs, like one of the not the totem, the actual running in board. The rest of this is all fictionalized, because nowadays this is part of the Castleman Trailway.
Nice.
So yeah. But I've sort of like added my own sort of spin on the area, like for example, you know, a signal box, the extra platform thingies, all that jazz. I just thought I wanted to make it look a little bit more pleasant, I guess. So here it is.
Yeah. This is where I'm quite happy. I can quite easily generate mental images.
Yeah.
So I can just see. Right now, because this was what, the 7 region?
Yeah.
I could just see sort of a T9 charging through the platform with enough express to.
You wouldn't have seen many express trains along here, to be fair, not in southern days.
No, but sort of like an express for this line.
Yeah, because it mainly ran local trains.
Yeah, sort of like a. Semi-fast to
yeah, it was also a diversionary route when I think it was when the Bournemouth electrification was being done, it was used as a diversionary route to get round to Hanworthy.
Nice. Yes. Wouldn't that then link it to the S&D?
Wimborne and Broadstone were where the S&D linked up to the London and South Western. There also used to be a branch line from Westmoor's up to Salisbury via Verwood, but that no longer exists either.
No.
Because what happened was, is the S&D gets down to Corbmullen, and then it goes down to Broadstone, which is where we were at the very beginning of this video. And then it came down to... it went down to Poole, and then along into Bournemouth West. So it basically used part of this line. So I could potentially use a Somerset and Dorset Railway locomotive on this line, or do a legitimate Somerset and Dorset style gala one day.
Yeah, because I mean you have the 7Fs. Which
mean? Well, you got the 7F. You could use a
GMT.
Yeah. We're coming up to the last section in this direction that we're going to be using the jub, because we're going to take the jub and we're going to leave the jub and the train here at the next station. Oh god, that's a lovely screenshot. The lighting is gorgeous. We're going to stop here and we're going to change over to a thumper to go on the mainline section after Holmesley. Only because it's easier to stop at Ringwood and let the engine get serviced here and let the DEMU go up to the main line and back.
Yeah.
Because, like I say, normal steam operation runs between Broadstone and Holmesley via Wimborne, Camford Bottom, Ferndown and Stape Hill, Westmoors, Ashley Heath, Ringwood and Burley. But...
Yeah.
Like certain gala days, for example, you may well see the DEMU either running from Ringwood or from Holmesley, and it runs up to Brockenhurst, which is up to... And also sometimes top and tail trains do use the line beyond Holmesley, but there's no runround facilities anywhere near Brockenhurst. So you'll see in a minute anyway, because it's a section I've just sort of re-scenerized a little bit recently. Excuse me.
I say. Anyway, Anthony... I hear you've taken your flash drive to the specialists today. Oh, the police have arrived.
That's what I thought.
Have they quote? How much have they quoted you?
They haven't yet.
Oh, okay. So what, you could. So you have no idea how much it might cost you.
Not yet.
Okay. Hopefully it ain't too expensive.
laggy there.
It's because it's loading up all the scenery and rolling stock at Ringwood.
Which reminds the game still drops frames when it loads its new trunks.
Yeah.
Time flies by when you're the driver of the train. Ah, what the fuck?
I don't know why I've been driving a lot. I've been driving a lot on the S&D recently.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of making me wish I could sort of route build.
Why?
Because I kind of want to do like a what if version of the route.
A bit like what I've done here.
Yeah, sort of a what if the S&D hadn't closed and was still open today.
You'd probably find it'd be a good freight route.
Yeah, plus, what I've been using a lot on it since I got the rig around the 50s in the sale. Not the 50s, modern. I don't know, I've been driving the Pacer along it a lot. Sort of both on the original DTG Somerset and Dorset route, and then the Bournemouth to Bath version of the route. And I've also sort of been using the old, technically the old HST in First Great Western livery with dynamic light lining. Because, from a standing start, from Evercreech Junction, the Pacer can, maintain a speed of 40 miles an hour going up the Mendips.
No, it can't, young man.
It fucking can.
It's fucking not allowed.
Well, it did.
So for the sake of the scenario, what we're going to do here, we're going to go and turn Windward Islands, run it round to the other end of the train and leave it there, and then we're going to get the DMU, move it into the platform, and then go down to Burley, Holmesley, and then we're going to run on the mainline section to Brockenhurst.
Nice.
So. Man, I love Stanier machines so much. Especially in certain lighting conditions like this.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just something about looking at, you know, Jubilee in these in this certain lighting conditions that make me think, I think it's also the fact that it looks quite realistic now I've got with my settings, doesn't it?
Mm.
Yeah, also. Thoughts just recurred to me.
Did it hurt?
Yes, a lot. But I don't know why. I want to see a Black 5 and a Jubilee double heading.
Tough.
Because I'm fairly sure it happens when.
We've got some wheel lock again.
Lovely. When Steam was in revenue earning traffic.
Don't you mean revenue earning service?
Yeah. It's tired. Late.
fuck's sake.
I was going to say, regarding the scenery stuff, have you heard there's a version 2 of the Railworks Enhancer coming out?
Oh, is there actually?
Yeah, it's a new product, though.
Oh.
But version 1.0 owners will get a discount on the version 2.0.
Cool.
And 1.0 will still get support.
Cool.
And updates, potential updates. But yeah, version 2.0 is apparently going to be like some amazing shit.
They said what will be in B2.
There is no indication as to what there will be. They said that in March, mid-March, we'll find out more information.
You know it's past March, don't you?
May.
Didn't
May.
Know.
I'm tired.
Everyone's
go away.
Tired.
But it is 11.
Prove it. Oh, wait.
11.
Waving through. Stop.
But it sounds to me like he's got even more, like, major breakthroughs going on.
What
wow, the wheels spinning. It's the hack that they use to make the wheels more advanced in train sim. It's bugging out. See, this is why I always say that the advanced scripts are actually just a bodge. Because train sim is just one big bodge. These advanced logos always going wrong. Send for another one at once.
Peep, peep, surprise, motherfucker.
You're in the bed. Oh my god, your hair's gone all weird. What the hell happened to your hair? You've gone properly. Have you dyed it then?
No.
Why has it gone blonde?
That's the
it's gone blondie.
Hair removal.
Hair removal?
Yeah.
Don't you mean colour removal, Trace?
Yeah, that's the one.
I'm going to say, I'd be pretty concerned if you're using hair removal.
Pretty too. Shocked if it went bald.
Yeah, it would be. Yeah, you can do that, but. Yeah, but you could probably dye that now and it'd be fine.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Well, I wasn't going to say anything.
Well, now you've just implied.
It's strawberry blonde. No, is that what it's called? Strawberry blonde? Yeah, strawberry blonde.
Yeah, that's
so,
it.
So, you're not live streaming, right?
Feelings.
People can hear you, right? Say something to my audience for a change. All 3,200 of them.
Goodnight.
She said goodnight. That's something.
Goodnight.
That,
yeah.
Goodnight. Okay. So long and thanks for all the fish.
Exactly. I'm going to beat you up later. Cuddles. Yeah. I'd like to see you try that with me, you frickin' fanny fart.
Tom, you fucking nugget, what the fuck are you doing?
I don't actually know. I think I'm talking to Tracy, but she just walked away. Wait, she walked away? What? No! No! Woman! Woman!
And then they what?
No, she's gone.
And she waddled away, waddle, waddle.
She did not waddle, for fuck's sake. Oh, God, she came back.
What do you want
to mean now? I'm not needy. Gwyn just basically implied that you're a duck.
Quack. Duck game. Duck game. Quack.
Now we're trying to cover his tracks by still talking about duck game.
The sheeps are about then.
Oh.
I don't live in the fucking valleys.
Still queer on your Welsh.
Wow.
Oh, she just slapped me. Oh, that really hurt. You see, people talk about abusive relationships, but they never talk about the women
well,
abusing the man.
Tom, that's
they?
What happens when you.
Oh my god, she's coming to get me.
Lies about your mates.
I'm not lying. She just literally went. She just hurt me.
No, I'm not on about that. I'm telling you that you lying to Tracy about what I said about her.
I was not lying to Tracy about what you said.
It's weird.
I've got it on string to prove it.
Oh shit.
Yeah, you dimbat.
That makes it worse.
Right, guys, let's keep this in mind.
You're a player.
Next time Guillaume comes in and starts chatting shit, don't tell him we're streaming.
That happens all the time, mate.
That's
not a rare occurrence.
Come knocking on Guillaume's door.
No fun about what, yeah. That obviously sounds not as fun about Riley. You do much better.
Well, I would be louder, but people are sleeping. I think Tom should crash that silly LMS loco and get a proper loco. Like, I don't know, some great Western.
Excuse me?
You heard.
Why being mean to my beautiful LMS locomotive?
Because it's LMS.
Because of what?
Because it's LMS.
Well, its genesis is with Great Western, so shut up.
Couldn't have an LMR influence.
Oh, Guion, you're going to...
get killed?
He's also going to love the Black 5 episode. Where I talk about Stania's Great Western roots. Especially with the Great Western's school of thinking when it came to locomotive design.
As you all know, the best to worst is Great Western at best. Then it's LNER, then it's LMS, and then it's Southern.
You know that's wrong, correct?
I was about to say.
It kind of goes LMS, Great Western, Southern, LNER.
Oh, no, no, no.
No, Tom, again, you've muddled up the GWR and the LNER.
I don't think I have, though.
No, LNER is way better than fucking Southern.
Get fucked.
No, thank you.
The only thing that Wood was doing was a sheep.
Gareth, are you pretending to be a sheep?
No.
Again.
I'm laughing at you. I'm laughing
Gareth,
at you.
Run.
I'm partly Welsh. I don't know if that doesn't help our case.
Or just...
He's partly Welsh because apparently he was breeded with...
My dad was from North Wales.
He breeded with a sheep, he did.
So Gareth is part sheep.
We all get Welshly.
It's like explains. I was going to say explains why he's a furry, but he's not, he's a brony.
So wait, Gareth likes to now fuck two species of animals, horses and sheep.
Sheep? Oh, that's nasty.
And this is why I'm hoping I don't bump into you at Comic-Con, Gareth.
Oh, you're going to Comic-Con, are you?
Yeah.
Well, James, you're stepping on my turf, so...
Yeah, but here's the thing. I'm dressing up, so, good luck identifying.
Nerds.
The very budget-based and the only Yuga person there.
Sorry, you're calling my cosplay, which I think I've currently spent like
time to
£200 on budget.
Well, people could spend over £1,000 on an outfit.
I think what I need now is for my costume to turn up, and then I can get my finger sized up for a ring, and it is.
Okay, so slight technical difficulty. My DEMU does not seem to want to be.
Your thumper doesn't want to work.
Yeah, my thumper doesn't want to move. I can't remember if I've done something wrong. Hold on.
You've obviously switched the master key.
Well, I clearly haven't.
Yeah, you've got the master key, you've... I mean, have you got the engine start up?
Yes.
It might need a cold start.
It shouldn't do.
Oh, your AWS went off.
This seems to happen to me quite a lot. I know how to start something up. I'm not stupid, yet the game decides it's not going to work.
It's because it's written by scripts, not by actual mechanical working things. So bugs occur.
Like your fat head?
Yes.
I say. Have you turned the knob, the stop park run? On the left hand side?
Just below the AWS.
What, the brake you mean? Yes.
No, no. There's a little turn key, try turn key thing.
In between the brake and AWS.
What, you mean the windscreen wiper?
No, the thing that indicates stop, park and run.
What is that anyway?
That's wiper control.
Yeah, I told you what it was.
I couldn't read the wiper control. I couldn't read because it was too far away.
He was illiterate. That's the word.
I'm actually dyslexic, but okay.
So you're stupid.
That's
okay. Obviously. That's interesting. What's just happened?
What's just happened?
I don't know.
Your engine's running. That's what's happening. Funny you say that, though. Despite my disability, I'm actually way beyond my reading and spelling age.
Why is it rocking?
I don't know.
That's the canter of the engine.
I seem to be having more problems with this than I thought.
It's on.
Press
the horn.
Can I make a suggestion?
What?
Hit it with a hammer.
I've tried moving them if I mention that. Because what those two lights mean.
But I tell you, you know what? I'm going to try this. Yeah, this thing's broken somehow. So, let me try this.
Train cell, everybody. It's buggy, but we love it. Some of the time.
So engine state is on. Reverser is currently 100%.
I mean, I've done the overload reset. I don't know how to restart.
Yeah, amateur's still at naught. So I think even though your engine is running, I don't think...
I should have put a 101 down.
Your whatchamacallit is actually generating power. There are other views. I'd check the other views.
Might have to pull the circuit breakers. Let's see if I can.
Above, I think. That's the line voltage which you are not using, so that's fine.
I'm just trying to reset the whole system, basically. Well, do you know what? I think it's buggered. I mean, that's the technical term for it.
Here's the not technical term. It's fuck, Jim, but not as we know it.
I'm just trying to press all the buttons! Nah. Do you know what?
Different server.
Oh.
The one that I have power in.
Oh, you mean the Brony server?
No. The one where I wielded the banhammer twice today already.
Oh, okay.
Very nearly three times.
Cool.
Because, yay, someone's been stupid enough to make me a mod. Jub Jub was being a Jub Jub at Jub Jub o'clock.
No, at the moment, it's all being fucking thrown away at fucking thrown away o'clock.
Thrown away o'clock?
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Goodbye, me little thumper. James, I don't really want to know what you're thumping, but... I said, I don't want to know what you're thumping. Let's use a bubble car.
Bubble.
I think what I'll do is go down to the main line and then load up the other version of the route, if that makes sense.
It quite possibly does.
Everybody's gonna die in 5 minutes. I'm gonna kill all of them because they're a bunch of bell ends.
But Tom's gonna die first.
Rude, but correct. Right, that should be fine. That should be fine.
Is he gonna, gonna die first? You know, with his issue.
Gav, calm down, you're going to hurt yourself.
I thought, no.
I say.
I'm going to kill you. Wait, what?
I'm going to kill again.
So from here to Brockenhurst is 11 miles, jeez.
Set an alarm for tomorrow morning.
No.
I think 7:30 is a good time. I'm being filmed tomorrow.
I think I'm sat behind Mr. Chairman, you know.
Why is that?
Well, look at the way the guy sat.
That is Mr. Chairman. Yeah, man. Can you see him from the orbital view? Freaking. The train goes honk honk.
She goes, hi.
What an ugly engine you are. Look at it. Network Southeast. Ugh.
Oh, shut up. What do you prefer, to be outside of the carriage or in the driving seat, anyway? Guys? Anyone? Guys? Ah, okay, well Discord has decided to disconnect. Me over for a bit then, boys and girls. Oh, there we go, I'm back.
Oh,
hello. I disconnected for a minute.
I just realized I'm the only one other than you here.
No, it's just me and you then.
Yeah
Discord must have done a derp.
Must have.
Anyway, I was asking whether you preferred it outside of the cab like I am now or inside the cab.
I
can hear people.
Discord
James
must
is
have
back.
Yeah.
Fine, James, can you help me?
What with, my good sir?
Outside of the cab like I am now, or inside the cab? I kind of like outside like it is now.
Yeah, I prefer outside.
You're going to see more stuff.
Huh?
You got to see more stuff from the outside.
Yeah, true.
Ah, there are people that are coming back.
Whatever.
I Thanos clicked my fingers and popped you out of existence, and then unfortunately some
what?
Rascals from Earth popped you back in.
Oh, did them.
Yes, yeah, quite nice to think that up until a couple of years ago, the bubble cars saw everyday use.
Yeah.
I like the chocolate and cream one. Yeah, that's a thought. Can you, in train sim, is there a quick drive consist for the rail motor and a auto coach?
And a what? Auto coach. No, I don't think there is.
Because you can do it. It is they are AC configured, so that would make it that makes them the first steam multiple unit.
That is very true. The only SMU.
The only SMU as far as no, that might not be true.
I mean, you know those. No, that was still a steam rail motor.
I mean, the very early DMUs were AC rail cars that had like these head coaches in the middle, which look really weird. But at the same time, cool. I'd have one. It was like a pair of AC rail cars that had flat, one flat end each, and then you had a B set coach in the centre.
It's also weird that the Ford rail car thing used on the Colonel Stevens Empire. Basically, it was like a Ford bus on rails.
Oh dear, yeah.
I can't, actually, do you know what? A single rail car on this route still doesn't look that bad.
I think it reminds me of sort of the route's sort of final years with BR reducing services down to
a single car train.
Yeah, a single car.
Even though that never happened on the Castleman, but I like the idea of it being a thing that could have occurred.
Stop yawning.
Who are you or someone else?
Me.
Oh, diddums.
Mm.
Oh, Rocky, wait, we've got collision in the morning.
No, but I do have training with some equipment and an audition.
Right, we have got to do this for the Molly bar, hopefully.
Suddenly, you can do 4D modeling.
Yeah, really, my metro needs to be fixed the frame, no, fix the texturing of it.
Nice.
Then add animation points.
Tom, have you got the lights on?
No.
No, okay, no, I was just thinking. Hang on. Where is lights?
What did that? No, I'm not accepting that.
So for those people who don't, even though I've explained it in several other streams, this station is the last one that never existed in real life on this route, Burley. Only because the town of Burley is literally, in real life, it's just over here. And it never had a railway station. And yet again, I thought, well, Burley's one of those towns in the middle of the forest. It's like it's a small community in the forest. It'd be nice if in, like, you know, preservation days, it did get its own station. My idea is that the Preservation Society moved in. They started out at Ringwood. And they would get their first aim was to get from Ringwood to Holmesley, but instead they had to terminate here at Burley first, and build a runaround loop here because of like issues with bridges and whatnot.
Hooray for bridges.
So like the original railway right back in the day would probably have Hang on. There we go, now it's going the wrong way.
I was about to say, Tom, you're going the wrong way, mate.
I know. Yeah, so they would have got to Burley, and invested in the bridging before getting to Holmesley, which became the railway's southern terminus. And whilst one team were rebuilding back towards the main line, the other team were building the other way towards Ashley Heath, Westmoors, and Ring, Wimborne.
Well, that reminds me of a discussion we had about the DRPS.
Yeah.
Sort of. Building a branch or something off the DR or something.
Yeah.
After Itchinavis or something?
Something like that.
Yeah. I can't remember what we decided to call it.
When we stop at home, I'm just going to go to the loo quick and get my mobile phone because I think it's still on charge downstairs.
And then we can go.
Well, yeah, what I'll do is I'll get to Brockenhurst and then I'm going to change over to the normal Southampton to Weymouth route and show you guys what this looks like going the other direction, but without all my scenery upgrades.
I'm guessing a little pants.
Well, you'll see.
It looks
in fact,
so
what I might do is I might actually go to the loo and stuff whilst we're on the section to Brockenhurst, because it's about 4 miles or 3 miles, I think.
Comes back derailed and crashed.
I hope not.
I'm gonna win it. Oh, there's smoke.
Yeah, I know. I need to still get rid of that at some point.
What's in the hillside? I thought it was like miles in the distance or something. I was like, where's it going now? Is there like a city on fire?
Floating scenery I just saw.
Oh dear. Oh yes, that's it. It's floating in the air. It's feeling moving a bit scar.
Well,
we are number 5.
Hey! It's time to mim.
It's time to die.
Well, we're approaching Holmesley, so...
Poop, poop. Come on.
It's actually 5.5 miles to Brockenhurst.
Brockenhurst, yeah.
Look how expertly I managed to stop.
Well, we're still watching you slow down, so not sure yet.
We're on a bit of delay. Don't forget
this. I just said that's my point. Fucking hell. A little slow this one today, isn't he? Yes, there was a very graceful stop.
Right, so that was... This is the terminus of the railway line as a preserved line. So I'm going to creep us over and out of the station and onto the main section. So I'm going to sit in the cab while we do this next bit because I'm going to go for a whiz and everything.
Whiz. In the meantime, I might switch to my laptop. Depending on where that is.
Well, I'll explain then. This bridge here actually still exists as well. And the station building exists as a tea room. But the main road into the New Forest runs over this bridge, which still exists in real life.
Mm-hmm.
But the railway line obviously doesn't. This bit here is now part of a road.
Wow.
Which I've driven on many times, I will point out.
It's sad to know that old lines are now roads.
Yeah, I know.
People were listening to George.
Anyway, if you look towards on the track side at our left, I'm going to zoom in a little bit to it. The shunting limit is about where that little sign is. So basically, a train runs off the head shunt and stops here because there's AWS ahead.
Okay.
So, for example,
there's a limited AWS ramp. It's an AWS ramp. It goes buzz off.
And then when we get to here, we're supposed to stop and obtain permission before proceeding. But that's mainly if we haven't already had permission, which we have. And as you can see, there are trap points being that are protecting this section of the line. So they're almost always set the other way, unless you're allowed to run on this section. Make sense?
Yeah, definitely.
So I'm just going to make sure we're like power setting, yeah. I'll be back in a minute then, everyone.
I shall also be back in a minute.
Oh gosh, Anthony. They've left us and the pony to deal with them.
What was it? What was that?
Nothing.
Dad, repeat yourself, please.
You'll just have to wait for the stream to be uploaded to find out, Gareth. AKA, I'm safe for a few hours, everybody.
You'll say it till I get back from college.
And then I'll probably be like, ah! My coursework is finally done.
Yeah. Come on, game, hurry the fuck up.
So, to the 13 people currently watching the stream, if you can, please consider subscribing to Tom's Patreon, which will help him with stuff such as Big Bob being made in TS, and also, once Tom gets into the swing of creating content, more content, you get early access to it. Sounds good, doesn't it? And if you pledge $5 or more a month, you have the potential to do a driver experience course. DLC and internet connection provided.
And you could potentially drive Big Bob once that goal has been reached. Let's hope Tom not listen to the stream while on his phone, while on the toilet.
Suddenly we just see on the stream, you cunts.
Oh, it's such an us thing to do, though.
Yeah. It's something Chris normally does, and I'm just like, well, the Norwegian fucker's not around, I'm stealing his job.
You're a Chris replacement service, not?
Oh dear, go tell Sophie that. Oh my.
What's that? Jane's been slow?
Yeah. There are Sly for the Sky Dragon's shoes, and I want them. Shut up.
I can't save you. I spend what? At least 200 per weekend I go away. I can't save shit.
Nope. Who have we killed?
Anthony.
Everyone's gonna die.
Hi, Tom. Hi, Tom.
Everyone's gonna die.
Again?
Well, I mean,
yeah.
Anthony's already died.
Doesn't surprise me.
Now Nathan's Misadventures. This single car, multiple unit is under control. How are we going to stop it, you ask? We're going to throw Gareth out the front.
Yeah, if we do that, we'll run him over and we'll derail.
Okay, throw him out the back then.
How's that going to make it any better?
Yeah, then we'll derail again anyway.
No. We slow down, and then Gareth's broken every rib in his body in at least two different places.
What do you think of this section of line anyway, James?
I think it is quite quaint in a way.
I like how the trees cast shadows over the line.
Yeah, that is nice.
Floating signal.
Yeah, I need to get rid of that.
It reminds, again, like with the use of the single car DMU, it reminds me of a railway line, sort of, on its last legs, in terms of, well, according to BR, anyway.
A Dr. Beeching axing. I still think Beach Boy, the Beaching Boys would have been a good team name.
Right, we're approaching Brockenhurst Lymington Junction, so.
Nice! And then it's sort of Hampton Weymouth time, isn't it?
Yeah. Right, by the way, here, right here, as you see, we're going through that gate there. That is the boundary for the Castleman's and Network Rail. So we're now on Network Rail.
Nice. So when will it not work fail?
In a minute. So on the right-hand side, you can see the junction for Lymington, which still exists. Yeah. And as you can see, we're now onto third rail, third rail rails.
Yeah.
Now, from this point onwards, there used to be a railway yard on the right hand side, and I'll show you it in a minute when we load up Southampton Weymouth.
Yeah. Say on Saturday.
What?
May the 4th be with you.
Oh dear.
Is that a... Oh, that's a 450.
No, it's not. It's a 444.
Sorry, yeah. Ah! I don't know an awful lot of third rail.
Are we on a 444?
So there you are, that is the Castleman's Railway up to re-scenerize that I've done to Brockenhurst. So basically what would happen on gala days is that you'd see that the 205, or if I get a 101 or something, would run up to here from Holmesley or Ringwood and then run back again between service trains. A bit like what the Wareham thing's going to do. Now I just want to see whether my 444 quickly, because there goes my my DMU is meant to be going somewhere else. So we're just gonna run the 444 quickly, just to see if my third rail electrification works.
should do.
It seems to. So now I can legitimately run part of the Great West, the Southwestern Main Line. So I might actually go through and actually modernise a bit more, so I can actually have a longer third rail run with these things on in the region where they actually work. Although, to be fair, it would be 450s in this area.
Yeah. Let me just double check something real quick.
Oh no, sorry, it is 444s that run this area. So I think the electrification at the moment only goes as far as there. So we're going to basically pick up speed and then the train's going to stop working. And then I'll swap over to Southampton Weymouth and show you what the differences are.
Okay.
What?
I can kind of tell how I got the 450s and the 444s confused a little.
They look exactly the same.
Pretty much. They're both in the zero family.
The only reason I've added this in and added that section, this section like this, is if I make a scenario that starts at Brockenhurst, I can realistically have some third rail locos running around.
Hmm? Sorry, I just had a message.
There!
And that's as far as the electrification runs.
Nice.
For now.
People wondered why their train was grinding to a halt.
No power. So anyway, let's now load up Southampton to Weymouth.
And go weesh.
Well, I'm going to have to load in at Ringwood and then go back to Brockenhurst.
Yeah.
And now we wait. Yawn, 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 yawn. Am I keeping you up, James? I hope so.
Yes.
Anyway,
considering I was thinking of going to bed at about 2 hours ago.
Oh.
And I was like, oh, Tom's streaming. Fuck it.
Right. I need to work out where we're going to start. We're going to start over here. Right, so, save change code scenario, no. So, as you can tell, we're now at Brockenhurst again, except now you can tell it looks a lot different. Wait for it.
That's semaphore signals. Oh, that's better.
So I noticed that one of my colleagues are watching the stream, so they said they wanted to see what this line looked like in the past, so now they're going to see.
Nice.
I'll just get the AP lighting enhancement on. Boom.
No.
Yeah, and go Chungus.
Nine of a thousand spotlights.
Right, so as this is Steam Era, we're going to have to use something Steam Era. I call for, let's see, Mournsels. I want Mournsels. So, Matrix Trains. We're going to go for Mournsels in the BR Southern Green era.
Nice.
And as we're on the Southern region, how about a Bully Pacific? Why not?
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Fun fact.
No.
Which will probably be repeated in my episode featuring the V2s.
No, it won't.
Yeah, yes, it will. The V2s were sent to help out in the Southern whilst the merchant navies and some of the light Pacifics were being rebuilt.
I think you're lying.
No, it's true. Even if I just double check real quick.
Well, we're going to drive a cheeky engine, 3069. Ha ha.
Not 69.
Now, it's called Hawkinge, but I call it Hawkminge because it's funny.
Yeah.
Right, get a nice longish train prepared. Oh, bugger, come on. That should be long enough for a bleed. So as you can already see though, guys, yeah, Brockenhurst looks a lot different in my version, don't you think?
Sorry, real quick, just double checking.
You prick.
Oh, I'm just trying to double check that I was actually incorrect.
Hold your dick and double click for porn memes. Right, actually, let's make Broadstone the final destination because that's where we're going to stop the stream. And does it take us up the Castlemans? Yes, it does, but it takes us the wrong road. Show then. Oh, wait, no. Taking us the correct road. Right hand side. Yeah, okay.
I could have sworn.
What?
I read somewhere that the V2s were drafted in.
Yeah, they were drafted in when the merchant navies were all taken out of service.
Yeah. Funny thing is, that's not on the LNER encyclopedia.
Funny that.
Yeah.
Almost as if they were embarrassed by it. Oh, God, what happened? Uh oh. Please tell me it hasn't bloody crashed.
Has it dumped?
The funny thing is, it hasn't actually dumped. It's just paused. Oh no, it's just dumped. Oh well, I'll throw my loading video up and we'll get this up again in a minute.
Huzzah! This is me.
I knew that would bloody happen, you know.
There's a lore about it, Tom.
Salt's law, isn't it?
Pretty much.
Well, I suppose it gives me a chance to go and get a drink.
Yeah. Oh.
Go jump off a drink.
I know that Chris isn't releasing this just yet.
I've just seen the renders of his. I don't know what that. It's like. It's a reverse patio tank.
Yeah, essentially, it's a condensed. It's a 440 condenser tank designed by George Lambie.
Oh, right. George the Lamb, Lambie.
Yeah, it's his CR1 class.
Okay.
And I think he said in his in Train Sim chat earlier.
Mm-hmm. Yes, James, you just sort of stopped.
Sorry, I zoned. What was I saying? I just completely zoned out for a second.
You're saying how wonderful I am.
I remember now. Yeah, I think he said in Train Sim Chat earlier, or Train Chat, that at least for now, the Lambie condenser tanks would be sort of just for him. But he is thinking of releasing it at some point.
I think the thing is, at some point we have to ask... let's have something from somewhere else. Like, let's have something just bonkers. Giant cheeseburger on toast.
Yeah, you know that survey?
No.
Chris put in the
I don't know it personally.
No, but you know that Chris plopped a survey in like a couple of weeks ago or so now.
Yeah.
And sort of when it said... One survey said, is there anything that Caledonian Works could improve on?
There's something wrong with the loco, because every time I click, I've just went to click on it again and it failed miserably. I'll have to rebuild this. I'll have to go into the scenario and edit it again.
Yeah, no, I think I put something like perhaps more pre-grouping locomotives from other Scottish railway companies, like the Highland, I know he's not a big fan of it, but the North British, the Glasgow and South Western, and maybe even sort of some of the pre-grouping Welsh locos,
like Taffel locos.
Yeah, and sort of I think the Rimney locos.
Rimney? Don't you mean rim job?
Yes, quite clearly. K&M class, I think, because that's what the 5600s were Swindon versions of, pretty much.
Right.
Dabba dabba do.
So I do have to kind of apologise to everyone for the boring loading screen at the moment. We are having techie difficulties.
AKA Train Sim is being the glitchy game that we love it to be.
I'm also blaming Guion for this.
Yeah. It's because that doesn't come with Locomotion 1.2 scripting, isn't it, Tom?
You know what? I think I've realised why it's crashing.
How?
I put a red flag down to dictate where the train had to go, and then I never gave it a destination. So every time I clicked on it, it was getting confused and broken.
Oh dear. Right, there we go.
So bear me one tick. Oh. Yeah, there we go. We're good. Right, let me just throw off the loading screen.
Oh, sugar.
So anyway. So this is what Brockenhurst looked like in the 50s?
In the 50s.
So it had the same platform arrangement, but obviously it had extra sidings. Ooh. That's what I could hear. I heard station announcement.
Oh, okay.
So anyway, we're gonna head off in a sec. So let's get ready and go.
What was 34069's name?
Hawkinge.
Hawkinge, or as you like to call it.
Hawkminge. So off we go then. Pretty Pacific in certain lights do look splendid, don't they?
Yeah, because that's what, BR Brunswick?
Yeah. Showing off its usual temperament for slipping.
It wouldn't be a bullied if it didn't slip, Tom.
This is true. Oh, got dancing headlights again for a minute. That'll do.
Mm-hmm.
I said dancing headlights. But as you can tell, on my version of the route as well, all of this track has been basically gone. It's just now forest.
It's just been gutted, yeah. She's still slipping, Tom.
Yeah, I think I may have maybe made her train a bit too long for the route, but oh well.
I'm sure it's fine. They're what, 7p?
Yeah.
And that's what we want.
I don't even know how many coaches this train got. Should manage it then, technically speaking.
Oh yeah, easily, it's bullied. You've got Sanders on.
Yeah. Got to, she won't make any speed otherwise. And I've got a big hill to climb in a minute. But you can automatically see the difference around here. You'll see it even more back on the Castleman proper. So let's see, the Castleman's railway from here to Broadstone is, 22 miles.
That's longer than the West Somerset.
Bearing in mind that this section here isn't technically part of the Castleman's.
No, it's the National Gateway.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, I can now just imagine the S&D was open now, sort of a horrible wet day, and you had a light Pacific slipping on the level coming out of Bath.
Oh, bloody hell.
Just imagine how much that would fucking struggle to get up the hill.
It would definitely need a 7F. Anyway, we're coming back up to Lymington Junction. And now we're on to Castleman's metal again. So, you know, I want to play Spot the Difference with everyone.
I've spotted a difference, Tom.
What?
There's a semaphore signal where there was an LED. Also, it was single track, wasn't it?
Yeah. My version is single track. And look at this bloody incline coming up. That's what I was talking about, James.
Oh.
It is a 1 in 44.
That's steeper than the gradient going between the Bromont and the Goflint.
Yeah, but it's not very long, thankfully. But I'm hoping that people can already see the differences between the scenery on this version and then the scenery on my version.
Yeah, no, I think it's mostly 2D trees on this, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you can sort. Oh, who have we killed?
Gwion, probably. He hasn't been talking for a while.
Unfortunately not. We've killed Gareth.
Oh. Is that worse?
Right, let's badmouth bronies. I wouldn't be surprised if we almost the next one to go. So I imagine the speed limit's a big difference as well.
Oh yeah.
Because if I remember at the start of the incline, I saw a thing for 80.
Yeah.
And I think at the top, I saw something saying 90.
Well, the limit is 90.
Cars off somewhere. You could imagine that being a diverted express from Waterloo or something.
Yeah.
So the whip I just noticed that this version uses the Western Lines of Scotland's whistle roars.
Yeah. Mine uses the one from the mid hands.
Yeah.
Also some of my bridges are different as well. In fact, no, more or less all of my bridges are different.
Yeah.
So now we're approaching Holmesley again.
Yeah.
So you'll see the layout's a bit different here as well. Or at least the scenery is. Because here is where my trap points are. Like on the next... Yeah. My trap points are where we've just gone through.
Yeah.
And this is where the siding is.
Yeah, where the Castleman's has some coaching stock.
Hmm.
50
minute. And then as you can see, Holmesley looks a bit different here.
Yeah.
For one thing, the station is a bit smaller.
Yeah, I was about to say.
It's smaller, slightly less detailed, has a little bit more in the way of siding space and whatnot, but the only thing that survives now is this building here, Holmesley Tea Room.
Yeah.
So next we come up to the two bridges where I've got, well, the first bridge where I've got a little speed limit over it.
Yeah, is it 15 you have?
Yeah. Oh, and then we're coming up to where that line side fire is.
Hooray!
Don't know whether we can see it on the side of the line in a minute.
Yeah, I see it.
So now we're coming up to where on the Castleman's Railway, the site of Burley Station, you'll recognise it because of the bridge going over the line.
Yeah. So I think it's just coming into view now on the stream.
It will in a sec, yeah, hold on. Yeah, here we go. Right here is where Burley Station used to be. Well, this is where Burley Station is on my fictional version of the route.
Yeah.
And then we've got Burley Bank.
I think Creon's asleep.
No, I'm awake.
Okay, I thought I heard you snoring.
No.
So what I just heard all of a sudden was...
Yeah. But yeah, the scenery is definitely quite different now.
Yeah, it's...
It's a lot blander.
Yeah.
Yeah. And a lot more 2D.
And flatter. Better way to describe.
Yeah, nothing seems to pop as much on this version, does it?
No. Which is quite sad, really. How's the fire doing on the lead?
I think I might need to put some more in. You're going to head off. Alright then, Graham.
Right here.
Alright. Night, mate.
Night, Graham.
Thanks for all the fish.
Something about fish.
Well, if you need to go, James, you go. I'm going to finish up.
I'm good. Sure. I've got training till like 10:30 in the morning, so... As long as I wake up at 8 o'clock and don't go back to sleep for 2 hours.
Huh.
Should be golden. Plus it's only what, 12:20?
Is it?
Yeah.
Holy cow, okay. Well, I better hurry up then.
It's not that late, to be honest.
To me it is. So we can now come back to Ringwood.
Yeah.
So this station looks a lot different. Now it's buried under an industrial park, basically. So in my version, there's a carriage siding, there's a loco shed over here, and in this version, as you can see, it's a lot different.
Yeah, there's sort of a big sort of derelict goods yard, and that bay platform, which isn't a permanent bay now.
Yeah.
And...
And then we come up to the bridges across the river, which... In this version, are represented wrong because that's a viaduct. You can also see that the track isn't done properly because, believe it or not, there used to be a long time ago a third line here. As you can see.
Yeah, where'd that go to?
That went to Avon Lodge, Herne, and Christchurch. It was part of the original Ringwood, Bournemouth, Christchurch, and Bournemouth Railway, which went off to the left.
Just there.
Yeah. And now we climb what is known on my route as Holly Grove Bank.
Yeah. Oh, Hawkins. Please tell me you're cool. I said the entrance.
Yeah, Hawkins. Hawkins.
Yeah, Hawkins seems to be handling it alright.
Yeah, that might be because our boiler pressure's gone right down. Because I'm trying to inject water.
Oh, yeah, injecting water. Kills it.
Yeah, now I've stopped injecting water.
The fire looks...
The fire mass should be fine now.
Yeah.
But yeah, those bridges going across there are absolutely wrong in this version anyway. They're more like on my route, which are girder bridges, like, you know, just straight over girders.
Yeah.
Now we're heading towards Ashley Heath anyway next, which as you'll see, as I'm going to zoom ahead to...
Yeah.
And as you can see from the stream in a sec, it was nothing more than a halt.
Oh, wow.
And you can see as well in this version where my shop is, it's just behind the station building. It's the white building. Do you see it?
Yeah. Yeah,
that's what is now my shop. Here. That was the crossing keeper's house.
Nice.
And there also used to be one single coal siding as well on the downside, which is where we've just passed.
Yeah, just seen Hawkins shoot through. Ooh, there we go.
What?
Oh, I just cracked my toes.
Ew.
It happens a lot. And there go my arms.
So now we're gonna. We've only got Westmoors and then Wimborne and Broadstone to go.
Yeah.
And then once we've done that, I'm gonna head on to bed, I think. So James didn't hear you.
Oh no, I was just muttering to myself.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's obviously I got my wig for my cosplay today.
Well, like I said, if you need to go to bed, then.
No,
no. Honestly, I'm not tired, really. It's just. I'm yawning because my brain's just like. Plus, I might even do some work on my mind mapping software.
Fair enough.
Yeah, for a personal project I've been meaning to do for a while. Probably can't meet for a few years anyway.
So what we're approaching here, it's not in my version of the route, but this yard that's here.
Yeah.
And then the railway line that's going off in that direction was the line to Verwood.
Okay.
And that went up to Salisbury. So Westmoor was technically a junction. That's why I imagined it to look like it did. But when you actually get to Westmoor's, it looks a lot different to my version, which is just here. So I kind of made a few like changes in the way it looks. Because in my version, it's sort of like the station building's on a slightly bigger angle.
Yeah. Also for that.
And there's also no bridge there.
Yeah. And I'm guessing that small little, what looked like a platform, was just a place for locos to rest.
Yeah, I think it was just a bay, like a loco bay or something.
Yeah. Say, in the unfortunate event that a locomotive failed.
It was stuck there and went.
And then BRB like, do we scrap you or do we fix you? What's the year? 1961. We'll fix you.
5 years later, the same thing happens. Ooh, what year is it? 1966. Scrap him! God, all these really crap 2D trees really detract from the scenery on this version, don't they?
Yeah, honestly, I'm just... Damn, can we get some 3D trees, please?
So, if you look to your left, mm-hmm. you can see Ferndown Industrial Estate.
Yeah.
Which is where... which is a real place and still exists. And as we come around this corner, when the line switches back towards the right, that's where the site of Ferndown and Stape Hill Station is on my version.
Yeah, because that's not a station.
Yeah, on this route there isn't a station here. But this bit here is what is now on my version known as Ferndown and Stape Hill.
Yeah.
So we're passing through what would be the platforms and now we're coming up to the siding where the green train was sat earlier and the level crossing. And as you can see, there used to be a siding on that side for one of the businesses in the industrial estate, but.
Yeah, I think it's all gone down.
So as we could just... Sorry, James?
You went robotic.
Oh, so did you.
Okay, Discord's having a fart, ladies and gents.
Seems to be alright now, though.
Oh yeah, it's behaving itself now. I think it just occasionally decides to go... and the servers are just like...
Right, oh, we're just coming up. Where this little box thing here is, this little, the signal and whatnot, this is where Canford Bottom Station is on my route.
Yeah, because you can probably tell. Right,
yeah, now. I've just gone through what is, on my version, Canford Bottom Station.
Mm. Just going to quickly...
Right, so.
Oh, that's better.
So now we're coming under to where that bridge I called the fly under was.
Oh, the dive under.
Yeah, the dive under, that's it. Basically, what I'm implying in my version anyway, is that this bridge was lowered slightly, or the ground was high, rained either side or whatever. So when the preservationists came in, they had a new bridge there, and they had to ask, they had to basically have highway maintenance build a bridge, a tunnel underneath the bridge, if that makes sense. And because it was such low clearance, it was a dive under.
Nice.
So now we approach Wimborne, at the, nearly at the end of the stream now.
It's what, Wimborne, then...
and then Broadstone.
I don't know why I kept thinking it... I keep thinking it's called Broadchurch.
Oh, God.
And I think that's in a completely different part of the country.
Yeah. So as you can see, the layout here is a bit different, because over there, where that good shed is the carriage siding now.
Yeah.
The bay platform is still there. Mm. The station building's a little bit different.
Yeah.
However, the one thing that hasn't really changed between the two routes is the siding layout here.
Yeah.
And the bridges haven't changed a bit, I don't think. Because as you'll see when we go over them, it's more or less the same.
Yeah, and if I remember correctly,
yeah,
just a little further up is where you have your turntable and engine sheds.
That's correct. That's what we're coming up to.
Yeah, and, I mean, obviously, I don't have Southampton to aim with because I probably don't have like half the bloody assets.
So what was here, James? As you can see, there was a turntable here.
Mm-hmm.
You've got the route to the left where we're going. Is the line up to Broadstone. The right hand side was the one that was for the S&D.
Oh yeah.
So we're saying in my history that the line to the S&D was taken up, but we built the MPD on the space where it once occupied.
Yeah.
And so the bridge we've just got over in the distance, that's the bridge that's now 1 in 25 because of the difference in height.
Ouch.
So I have sort of been sympathetic to the original.
Yeah.
And then, of course, all this scenery around here has been revamped as well.
Yeah, because you use a different turntable there, don't you?
Yeah. So when we get there, I'm going to show you where the site of my Broadstone station is versus where the site of the original was.
Hmm.
But I tell you what, for climbing hills and whatnot, as a preserved route, I find this a very fun line. Because you've got, like, for example, you've got basically, you climb from Holmesley all the way to Ashley Heath, and then you're basically going downhill to Wimborne, and then up and over to get to Broadstone.
Yeah, which is...
Which is why we're struggling again.
Yeah, walk inch will make it.
Well, we're on a 1 in 100 at the moment, so I hope so.
Zach, I think a P2 is being made for train sim right now, isn't it?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know if Chris is making one at the moment.
Yes, and Chris is, I think. Chris is making one, but it's sort of like not ready yet.
Yeah, and then someone else is making one and they're sort of waiting on an update from the P2 Society or something. It's a big developer. I say big developer. Chris is a big developer, so. Oh, fuck. It's not DT.
I don't know, James.
No, neither do I. That's gonna bug me.
Right, okay, so where we're coming up to now, this signal is where the signal is to the entrance to my version of Broadstone Station. Because you'll see in a minute that we come around this curve, and on the very end of the curve is where my version of Broadstone Station is now.
Yeah.
In fact, let me just come up and have a look. Yeah. Where the curve is here, where that pillbox is where my Broadstone Station sits.
Mm-hmm.
So if I just, ease off there. So where we've just passed is basically where the station on my route lives. The original station was down here, where that bridge was, like I said earlier.
Mm.
And the line that goes off here as we come in, the line that goes off to the left there, James, you might be interested to know, was the Somerset and Dorset line.
Nice.
So basically, the Somerset and Dorset, if I show you on the map, when basically you'll see on the map, the two triangle ends are there.
Yeah.
So they joined up at Corfe Mullen.
Yes, because on the...
On the Bath to Bournemouth route, yeah.
You go through Broadstone.
Yeah.
At supposedly 30 miles an hour and definitely don't thunder through it like 50.
Yeah.
Or higher. And definitely never derail.
So what I'm going to do, because the loco is going to basically throw up a game over ending in a minute, I'm going to end the stream here after the train comes in. So that was my rebuild of the Castleman basically done. There's a few bits to do, but other than that, I'm happy with it. And this was me going back along the, old version of it. So, thanks everyone for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you enjoyed seeing how much has changed between my fictionalized version and the real-life version that used to be.
Nice.
So, as Corkinch slides past after our final destination was reached, I will see you all next time. Goodbye.